know what, this is my first major and I've pulled an Olympic silver medalist, a world silver medalist, and a European silver medalist or gold, whatever, and he used to be a heavyweight. So for me to see that, I went in there and I wasn't outclassed, it just gave me confidence to see that I can mix it up with the top weights. I've only been international level, like I said, for about a year and 5 months, but they've been on there probably before I even started boxing, so it was good to see that.
The end of the round, but there's still some seconds left here. He's just about got away with it. Just about got away with it. He almost falls on his way back. Mullenberg is all out in the corner.
Go in there with someone like that level, you can mix it up and possibly have won the fight. So it's all bonuses, all bonuses. Yeah, just the training, just you have to put everything into it. So when you go in there, know that you're capable of doing anything. And for me, I make sure I have hard sessions, you know. I make sure sometimes in sparring, I really get stuck in. So if it gets hard in a real fight, I can just remind myself and be like, oh yeah, I did this in sparring. I've been in a war in sparring. I've been out boxing people in sparring. I've been hitting hard in sparring. So if it happens in a ring, I'm like, this is second nature to me. The harder you train, the more doubt you remove. If you know you've run hard, sparred hard, worked hard, it removes the doubt in your head. You know, the other guy may have done the same, but it's also about believing, you know. I know that if I hit this guy with my jab, he's going to be strong, he's going to feel it. He might have the hardest chin, but I still believe that he's going to feel it.
Big punch, the end of his left hook.
It's a bit like when you play fight night, you know, when you hurt the person and you're tired, your energy bar goes up and you can kind of close down on them. Same way in boxing, if when you're fighting and you come with a good exchange, or you see that they're bleeding or something, you get this extra burst that enables you to come forward. I come with better of the exchange. Psychologically, I'm one up, I'm ahead of you, and I can step within range and do it again. And I'm going to try and do it over and over again until you're defeated. As I don't know how pretty it looks outside, but inside, it is how it's said, you know, it can be a dangerous sport. When you're training, it's just, for me personally, I just say it's just about 90%, 80% physical, just pushing your body physically all the time. And when it's fight night, you all know everyone's fit. It's just about who can execute what they've got to do on that night. You know, you may have beaten me 20 times, but if Friday comes and Friday night, I've got my stuff right and you haven't, I'm going to come out victorious. So just, it changes, you know, on the night of the fight, it's more mental than physical. You can't build muscles on the chins. So you know, you might look at person and be like, wow, he's got big abs, he's strong, he's quick. But you know that you hit him hard on the chin, he's gonna feel it. That's the thing, no matter how rough you've been brought up or whatever, you've all got that thing, you know, you get hit on the chin, it's gonna hurt. And if his chin is gonna go down, it's still gonna hurt. Well, a lot of confidence to know that I've run hard, I sparred well, I've, you know, done my extras in the gym or whatever, but for me, mainly, it's what I read in the Bible, you know, scriptures and stories from like Samson, from David, to see that God can enable these guys to, you know, physically fight a fight and become victorious. Look at David and Goliath, look at God giving Samson the strength to overcome all these soldiers, you know, I kind of feel on stuff like that, to make me think he's just a mere man, he's a mortal man, he's a human being just like myself, so. But you go in there and, you know, you see what happens. Humility, you have to be very, very humble. You know, anything can happen. Be confident, but I always believe to be humble. You know, everything can happen. At a blink of an eye, you can go from being number one to being right above. You know, so I always believe in being humble. You need to be consistent. I mean, the training, every day I do something. You know, even when I'm meant to rest, I'll take a rest. But I'm kind of doing something to keep the heart working. So you need to be humble, you need to be persistent, and I say you need to be confident as well. Find confidence in something. You know, for me, like I said, it comes in what I read. So I step in there and I might look at the guy and be like, you know what, I know I can beat you, but I'm relying on things that I've read to come to life for me to kind of overcome the person. So those are the three words for me. Hey, bro. wow, why boxing, that you can choose another sport? Yeah, like, I don't know, trying to think of an easy sport, do snooker or something. Something, just, don't get me wrong, they concentrate at a higher level, but you know, just something a bit less physical. You know, but just wake up, you think to yourself, if I'm not doing this, my opponent is doing it. You know, the time I'm staying in bed, he might be out there training. What I'd say is surround yourself with people that kind of are in the same path as you. The thing about me is that most of my friends, they all box. Yeah. You know, we train during the week, go to uni, work, whatever, and on the weekends, the phone goes off, what are you doing today, Josh? Okay, I'm training, meet me at the gym at 10. Boom, we're at the gym at 10. We're training, after training, we go out, we eat. We might go to like a dinner party at someone's house or whatever, but we're always, we've got that same goal. We want to train, we want to get fitter, we want to do better. I wouldn't put myself around my old friends that didn't want to do that. They didn't necessarily want to be elite athletes. They had different pathways that they wanted to take. So I put myself around the people that wanted to get somewhere in terms of sports, and specifically for me, boxing. And that's kind of what's helped me.
So winning gold last year, what sort of mindset does it put you in going into Rio?
It reminds me that I'm capable of, you know, qualifying and going out to medal. I beat a guy that I lost to twice in the finals, Willenberg, so for me it was kind of a good way to end the year, you know. I felt the first time I boxed him, I beat him, but they gave it to him. The second time we won fair and square, the third time we boxed, I won. So it's kind of put me in a good place to know that, you know, I'm capable of beating someone like that, that may have got two wins over me, to kind of bounce back from it. So for me, it's all good.
Yeah,